friends, I'm Sharayu Pujari and I'm an educator on Academy. So you can follow me on Unacademy learning app where you can find my other courses as well. So this lesson is on some MCQs related to wastewater engineering or introduction to wastewater engineering. In this we are going to see some 1 mark questions asked in GATE exam. So please do rate, review and recommend my courses. Share this video and subscribe us on YouTube channel. Thank you.
Hello friends, welcome to Unacademy and this lesson on MCQs related to Introduction to Wastewater Engineering Part 2 by Sharayu Pujari. About me, I have completed my M.Tech in Environmental Science and Technology. I have completed my B.E. in Civil Engineering. I have 2 years of experience in teaching and you can follow me on this link. So if you follow me, you will get notified every time I publish a new lesson or new course. So this is my profile. Here you can find my other courses as well on an Academy learning app. So please do rate, review and recommend my courses and lessons. Also do share this video and subscribe us on YouTube channel. So friends, this is the part 2 of MCQs. As I have earlier said in my last lesson on MCQs that we are going to see some 1 mark questions related to wastewater engineering here. This 1 mark questions are also relatively important because the questions may seem simple but the options make the questions confusing or difficult, right? So for that purpose, you need to practice more and more MCQs so that you will get it easier in the exam. So let's see the first question. The question is, the water carriage system of collection of waste products is preferred to dry conservancy system when? So friends, here the options are given. Option A, it is cheaper in initial cost. Option B, it does not require treatment before disposal. It is more hygienic in nature. And option D is, it is easier to maintain. So I want to tell you that before this, you need to know that there are 2 types of collection of waste products. The first one is the dry conservancy system and the next one is the water carriage system, right? So what happens in dry conservancy system is that the human and animal waste like feces and urine are collected in pans from laboratories and is then carried by laborers into carts or lorries for disposal, and generally disposal is outside the city, and there it is buried for manure, right? So this is the dry conservancy system. And in water carriage system, water is used to carry the sewage waste from one point to another point, and then their treatment is done on the wastewater, and then that treated wastewater then can be disposed of in the river or any other source, right? Or other treatment can be done. So what they are asking in this question is, the water carriage system of collection of waste products is preferred to dry conservancy system because. Why it can be preferred to a water carriage system can be preferred to a dry conservancy system? If we see that it is cheaper in initial cost but it gives more maintenance, so this is not the answer. Next is, it does not require treatment before disposal. Yes, dry conservancy system does not require any treatment before the disposal, but water carriage system needs treatment before the disposal, right? So next is, it is more hygienic in nature. So as compared to water carriage system, dry conservancy is not at all hygienic in nature, and also dry conservancy is not easier to maintain, right? So option B here is the correct option for this question. So the water carriage system of collection of waste products is preferred to dry conservancy system because it does not require treatment before disposal. So generally this dry conservancy system is not active nowadays. People are not using that. If it is in a rural area where water scarcity is more, that place or they can adopt this dry conservancy system, right? So option B is the correct option for this question. So the next question is, the wastewater coming from kitchens and bathrooms is popularly known as, option A is domestic sewage discharge, option B is sewage discharge, option C is drainage discharge, and option D is none of this. So let me tell you that if you have seen my first lesson on this course, so we have seen some fundamental definitions that you need to remember. The definitions like refuge, garbage, rubbish, sewage, sewage, stormwater, etc. So what is a sewage? It is a wastewater from bathrooms, wash basins, kitchens, which are less foul in nature. So this definition is of sewage discharge. So the wastewater coming from kitchens and bathrooms is properly known as a sewage discharge. Please do remember this term, which can be asked in exam, right? So option B is the option correct option for this question. Next question is, for the design of sewers in India, the percentage of sewage discharge is assumed as, first option is 25 to 30% of water supplied from waterworks. Option B is 75 to 80% of water supplied from waterworks. Option C is 100% of water supplied from waterworks, and option D is none of this. So friends, let me tell you that the water is supplied to us by the water supply system or waterworks, right? That water we consume for many works like bathing, cleaning, gardening, etc., right? So while doing that activities, we use the water, and then the remaining water is then converted into wastewater, right? So that percentage is generally taken as 75 to 80% of water supplied from waterworks is converted into wastewater, right? So, for the design of sewers in India, the percentage of sewage discharge is generally 75 to 80% of water supplied from the waterworks. So, this factor is actually very important in wastewater design system, because wastewater engineering, because this factor we have seen that it is in the estimation of dry weather flow and wet weather flow, and the design of sewers will also need this. So please do remember this factor, which is 75 to 80% of water supplied from waterworks is taken as sewage discharge for the design of sewers in India. So option B is the correct option for this question. Next question is, the ratio of minimum hourly flow to the average flow of sewage is, option A is 1/3, option B is 1/2, option C is 2/3, and option D is 3. So for this purpose, first you need to know what is minimum hourly flow and average flow of sewage, right? So for that I have given some formulas. So why minimum flow is important? Because at minimum flow, the velocity reduces, therefore silting occurs in the pipelines or in the sewers, right? So the slope at which sewer is to be laid is decided based on permissible minimum velocities at minimum flow. For that purpose, this minimum flow computations or formulas are very important, right? So according to that, the minimum daily flow is equal to 2/3 into average daily flow, and minimum hourly flow is 1/2 into minimum daily flow. So this minimum daily flow is 2/3 into average daily flow. So 1/2 into 2/3 into average daily flow will give us 1/3 into average daily flow. So this they are asking the ratio of minimum hourly flow by average daily flow, right? So it will be 1/3. So the correct option for this question is option A, that is 1/3. So the next question here is, point out the wrong statement in the following assumptions generally made in the design of moderate sized sewers. So for moderate sized sewers, they are asking, point out the wrong statement. So the first statement they have given, that is option A, that is average daily flow is equal to annual average daily flow. Option B is minimum daily flow is equal to 2/3 average daily flow. Option C is minimum hourly flow is equal to 1/3 average daily flow, and option D is none of this. So friends, here these formulas I have explained previously, so please go through them, and according to that, none of the above statements are wrong. So none of this is wrong. So option D is the correct option for this question, which is related to the design of moderate sized sewer, right? So next question is, a space of 1/4 to 1/3 is left vacant in the design of sewer pipes at maximum discharge due to. So why 1/3 or 1/4 space is left vacant in the design of sewer pipes at maximum discharge, they are asking. So the first option is possible low estimates of maximum and average flows. Option B is large scale possible infiltration of storm water. Option C is unexpected increase in population, and option D is all of the above. So as per we have seen all the lessons till now in this course, so if we see that all the above factors are correct, right? So the space of 1/4 to 1/3 is left vacant in the design of sewer pipelines. At maximum discharge, they are due to there will be possible low estimates of maximum and average flows, and due to that there may be some problems. So this 1/4 or 1/3 space is left vacant, right? And then next is large scale possible infiltration of storm water can come. It can be happen. And next is unexpected increase in population. Yes, it can also happen. So all the above factors are responsible for the leaving the 1/4 or to 1/3 space vacant in the design of sewer pipes at maximum discharges, right? So option D is the correct option for this question, that is option D. So in this way we have solved some more MCQs related to introduction to wastewater engineering. So thanks for watching the video. Do share this video and subscribe us on our YouTube channel. Thank you.